you live on this glorious morning in Venice. I decided to sneak out of the studio this morning, have a little weekday brunch at Clutch Roadhouse. And guys, this is a true smokehouse. You can tell by the stacks of wood behind me. And one of the best parts about this restaurant, it is owned by one of the stars of This Is Us. Any guesses who it is? Any guesses? Any guesses? Okay, let me give you a clue. He looks a lot younger in real person than he does on TV. Any idea of who I'm talking about now? All right, I want you to wait any longer, so let's go inside and say hello. Look who it is, everyone. It's John Wirtz.
Hey, what's going on?
What's going on, John?
I'm just getting ready to open.
You own the place.
I do. I'm one of a few.
Oh, one of a few. So,
yeah.
This Is Us. We all know you as Miguel. You're married to Mandy Moore's character on the show.
Rebecca,
but
yes.
People don't know about this side of you. What made you decide to open a restaurant?
I live in Venice, and Venice has been going through a metamorphosis over the last, I would say, 15 to 20 years.
Yeah.
And I noticed a change. A guy that I met about 15 years ago, my wife and I, we were just dating, really, you know, just started getting into wine and wine tasting, and there was a place called Venice Beach Wines that my partner, Oscar Armasillo, and his wife opened, and we... you know, we started going there. We met his wife, Norma, and we just, you know, really fell in love with the whole vibe, and they had great wines, and we told them, and they changed the neighborhood with this thing. On Rose Avenue, there was nothing really going on. It was like a couple of old businesses that were there that were, you know, old hats that people loved, but it was nothing like Abbot Kinney, and I feel like Oscar and Norma with Venice Beach Wines and Cerveteca kind of made Rose Avenue kind of start to blossom.
Yeah,
The rose started to blossom. So we decided, we'd love to help continue that in Venice, like blossoming the neighborhood and making it a place where people have somewhere to go that feels like a neighborhood vibe. So that's where we came up with this concept, Clutch, and it's a family restaurant. You know, Norma and Oscar are like a brother and sister to me and my wife, and his parents are partners, and a lot of his family works here.
Well, let's get to the food.
You want to check it out?
Yeah, so what kind of food will you get here?
The restaurant's inspired by Santa Maria barbecue kind of flair. Oscar and Norma have been sourcing a lot of wines for Venice Beach Wines from Baja of Mexico.
Yeah.
And there's a wine region down there that we have gone with them to called Valle de Guadalupe, which is where you can find all these amazing wines, but there's also these amazing restaurants that cook over an open flame, smoke a lot of their food.
Yeah.
So we decided that's what we want to do here. We want to, you know, introduce this kind of a barbecue-inspired, Mexican-inspired. We've got wings. We've got veggie beans, so we're vegetarians and vegans. We've got cheesy grits. We've got, of course, seafood. We're on the coast, so why wouldn't we have seafood here?
I'm going to get right in this.
We have all of these proteins. This is a pulled pork. This is
so
a tri-tip. Everything has got our signature rub, and we smoke everything, and we can do it. We serve it taco style a lot.
Can we talk about the drink?
This
is a margarita, but it's a little different.
So it's a margarita. We have a beer and wine license here. We don't have a full liquor license.
But
because, you know, my partners are experts in wine, we were able to source an agave wine. So instead of it being distilled, it's actually fermented from the agave plant. It's from Mexico, and it tastes exactly like a margarita, maybe even a little bit better. What do you think?
This is wine.
This is wine, agave wine.
Oh my goodness!
But it's we have to use two shots instead of one to get the same kind of strength and proof that you would have in a tequila margarita. But people love them; they're very refreshing. It's great for a summer day.
Yeah.
We've got our Bananarama dessert in case
this
you
is so
have
great.
Had enough protein in me, which is kind of I think this is a comfort food right here. I mean, look at it; you can actually get 2 pounds heavier just by looking at it.
What do your castmates think about the food? They've been here, right?
Chris Sullivan has been here more than anybody because he lives so close. But they like it. I mean, not everybody's been yet because we're all spread out. But they love it. But, you know, for us, it's more about the neighborhood. We really want to be a neighborhood place. A place where people come and feel like they're sitting among family and friends.
And they enjoy it all. Okay, one quick secret for the upcoming season. Anything you tell us? Anything.
Yeah, I can tell you one thing.
What is it?
Miguel's hair is a little curlier this season than any other. easy.
Look at him. He's like 20 years younger than he looks on TV. I love it. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
John. Jess, I have a lot to dig into right now, so we'll bring you back a little bit.
We can send some back to the studio.
Yeah, we'll box it up.
Okay. There you go.
All right. Bring me back that margarita because it looks so amazing. And that's so interesting.
It
definitely looks like I just added a place on my list to visit over the Labor Day weekend. So I'll see you later, Danny.
I'm getting the wings.
Bye.
You got to put the sauce on.
Oh, yeah.